Hello, welcome to our first edition of Red Devils TV. Today we're going to interview our principal, Mr. Jones, and our counselor, Ms. Martin, about their thoughts on our sports broadcasting program. Here are their thoughts.
What are your thoughts about our school starting this broadcasting class?
I am very excited about this broadcasting class because one of the reasons I'm a sports center fanatic, and I watch that program every morning before I come to work, and I'm amazed at the things that they're able to do behind the scenes to bring sports to life. And I'm looking forward to this class doing the same thing, not only for Lawrence County High School, but for the entire county, and also on the state and the national level, that we can create some sports broadcasting right here at Lawrence County High School.
How do you think this class will benefit our athletic program and school?
It's going to be a great benefit to our program and school because it's going to allow us to communicate with an outside world. I think once we download the app and we can live stream our events, and that's going to be for our parents or grandparents or aunts and uncles who cannot make ball games or club events, they can download the app and watch the game live. I think it's going to be amazing. It's going to give our students an opportunity to enter into a whole new career, a whole new part of life, and all those things. So I'm looking excited. I'm very excited about the program and looking forward to it.
What are your expectations for this class?
My expectation for this class is to be the best that they can be, to have those talents that we have within our school to come out in this sports broadcasting program. I get excited every day when I see the excitement in the students that are in this class and how they're going about their business. I'm really looking forward to that and them accomplishing their goals and dreams.
For everyone watching, we wanted to know, what's your favorite home-cooked meal?
My favorite home-cooked meal would be cornbread, turnip greens, pinto beans, fried chicken.
Your thoughts about our school starting this sports broadcasting class?
I am really excited about the sports broadcasting class because it's allowing our kids to use their talents and their gifts and to see the behind-the-scenes activities that are related to sports events.
How do you think this class will benefit our athletic program in school?
I think this program is going to increase our school spirit. It's going to increase student involvement in athletic activities. And it's going to help our kids learn more about technology and public communication, technology, all of those things.
What are your expectations for this class?
I expect the kids to have fun. I expect them to learn a lot. I expect this program to increase our student involvement in athletic events and to just increase our school spirit overall.
For everyone watching, we wanted to know, what is your favorite home-cooked meal?
It's my house.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you, Mr. Jones and Ms. Martin, for taking your time and allowing us to interview you. Now let's talk about our football team and the performance from past Friday night's game. Your Red Devils took on the Hartsville Tigers in a non-region competition. The Red Devils fought hard but came up short. The final was Hartsville 41, Red Devils 14.
Now let's take it to head coach Rich Dutton, senior outside linebacker Jordan Jones, and senior running back Noah Barton.
Does the outcome or this game have any meaning on how the rest of the season will go?
That's really up to the players. You know, playing a team like Arsenal, you hope you got a good measuring stick to figure out where we're going to go from here. They should be the toughest opponent we face this season. So if players have a sense of competitiveness about them this season, we'll find out after this game.
Why did you choose to play Arsenal the first game of the season?
Like I just said, you know, we needed somebody that could kind of tell us where we're going to be this season. We need somebody that the program is good enough to bring money into our program, help us out financially, and also challenge us in the game field so we can figure out our holes. So I play Hartsville every season.
How do you think your team performed?
You know, looking at the small things, I thought they did really well. There's several times defensively that they stood up to tough situations. And, you know, the offensive line of Barton having that chance to strike one out in the middle of their teeth, you know, that was a good sign of something we hadn't done in the past.
How do you think the rain delays affected your players?
I don't think it did. I think our players now are mature enough they can handle some adversity. Last season was 7 overtimes. This season is lightning delay. I think they're about ready to weather anything that's thrown at them.
What is your biggest learning point from this game?
It's good question. You know, I don't think that's really going to be known until after we play a couple teams like Russell and Brooks. I'm not sure they'll answer that question. Right now, I don't know. Thank you, George.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Mr. John. See y'all.
What was the Jordan? What was the main goal for the defense this week?
To shut down Hornsville's offense and put our offense in good field position.
Also, Jordan, who was the main threat for Hornsville's offense coming into this week?
I'd say it would have to be Jordan Sober, considering he had a really good game against Coleman.
Noah, how do you feel averaging 9.2 yards a carry?
Good.
Jordan, what impact did the defense? What impact did the defense have in the game?
We set the tone.
Noah, what were your main goals going into this game for the offense?
Just clean up everything for real. That we take impact on the offense.
Thank you, Coach, and senior players for your time.
Our state runner-up volleyball team played a tournament in Jacksonville this past weekend. They went 4-4, lost Alexandria, Oxford, Benjamin Russell, and Clay Chalkwood. They beat Shades Valley, Ramsey, Madison County, and Lee.
Now let's go to the senior player, Brady Gardner, for her thoughts on this past weekend.
Camera.
What was your overall thoughts about how your team performed this weekend?
I feel like we performed really well, but like we got more and closer together at the end, and we pulled off a big win.
How important is winning every game to you?
It's very crucial, especially when we want to go to state.
How did this weekend prepare the team for the rest of the season?
It showed us what we needed to improve on, like as far as practice and working together and stuff.
What are the things that you think need to happen for improvement?
We need to communicate more, and we need to keep an upbeat, high energy, so we can go to state.
Thank you.
Thank you for your time. Our back-to-back state champions cross-country team had their first meet this past weekend at Bolton Mini Park. Our girls came in fifth and our guys came in seventh place. Here is our interview with Ms. Childress and our boys runner, Roberto Rillis.
What's your opinion about the boys and girls' performance at the race Saturday?
Well, I thought the girls, they done well. From what we, thought they would do. They done better than what we really thought they would do. And the guys, the top three done really well. We're lacking in the fourth and fifth runner. So we're hoping that next week that we'll have two that have stepped up.
Okay. What's your outlook for this cross-country season?
I look for the both teams to keep improving each week, and our goal is to get Scottsboro, and we're not that far. It's not something that can't be done.
What's your main goal for the team this season?
Well, our main goal is always to win state. So that's what we're aiming for and hope to get again, a third time in a row.
How does this cross-country team and coaches prepare for a race?
Well, our team works very, very hard every day at practice. We have different things set up. They'll have intervals, long runs. Today we're going to the mountains so that they get practice on hills. So it's something different every day for them to prepare for a race.
What's your expectation for this race Saturday at Wilson High School?
To beat Wilson and Scottsboro. Okay, and to knock some time off of their previous race. Hopefully that each person can do that.
How did it feel to see your principal at the finish line?
It felt good because, he's a big cross-country supporter, and I think it just gave the team a little bit of confidence seeing there at the finish line.
How do you feel your team performed Saturday compared to last year?
I think we did pretty good. I mean, every year we're stepping it up and advancing, so I think we did better than last year.
How did you and your team prepare for the race?
Just a lot of practice, hard working, pushing it every day. A lot of mileage.
I'm Dan.
Thanks for tuning in to this week's edition of Red Devils TV. See you next time.